मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ क्लिनिक इज सडनली मैच्योर कैटरेक्ट इन कंजेनाइटल कैटरेक्ट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी स्टडी अबाउट द लेंस। लेंस इज अ ट्रांसपेरेंट बाइकॉन्वेक्स क्रिस्टलाइन स्ट्रक्चर प्लेस बिटवीन द आयरिस एंड द विट्रियस। द डायमीटर ऑफ अ क्रिस्टलाइन लेंस इज अराउंड 9 टू 10 मिलीमीटर्स। वेट इज अबाउट 135 मिलीग्राम टू 255 मिलीग्राम। द एंटीरियर सर्फेस ऑफ द लेंस इज लेस कॉन्वेक्स कंपेयर टू द पोस्टीरियर सर्फेस। रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स इज अराउंड 1.39 एंड पावर ऑफ द लेंस इज अराउंड 18 डायोप्टर्स। कमिंग टू द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द लेंस, लेंस द एंटीरियर सर्फेस ऑफ द लेंस इज लेस कॉन्वेक्स कंपेयर टू द पोस्टीरियर सर्फेस। द न्यूक्लियस ऑफ द लेंस इज डिवाइडेड इन टू फोर टाइप्स। इनर मोस्ट इज द एम्ब्रियोनिक, देन ऑफ द फिटल न्यूक्लियस, आउटर देन इन्फेंटाइल, देन अडल्ट न्यूक्लियस एंड After nucleus there is a cortex, cortical part. Then there is a anterior epithelium and the posterior epithelium. A cataract word is derived from the Greek word cataractus, which means a waterfall. The term refers to the development of any opacity in the lens or its capsule. Cataract occurs either due to formation of opaque lens fiber, that is it can be congenital and developmental, or because of the degenerative process leading to opacification, that is acquired cataract. Cataract is the leading cause of blindness worldwide. Coming to the etiopathogenesis, risk factors for cataract are old age, then sunlight containing ultraviolet A and B rays, severe diarrheal dehydration, vitamin deficiency like vitamin A, C and E deficiency, then diabetes mellitus, smoking, corticosteroids and other genetic factors. Etiological classification consists of congenital and developmental cataract and the acquired cataract. Acquired cataract is again consists of senile immature cataract, traumatic cataract, complicated cataract, metabolic cataract, electric cataract, radiational cataract and toxic cataract. Cataract associated with systemic diseases like Down syndrome, Lewy syndrome, parathyroidectomy, myotonic dystrophy, galactosemia and atopic cataract. Coming to the morphological classification, morphological classification is depending upon the type of opacities developing inside the cataract. So it can be either a nuclear cataract or cortical cataract. Then surrounding the nucleus, you can see there is lamellar cataract. Then anterior subcapsular cataract or posterior subcapsular cataract, coronary cataract and pyramidal cataract. Polar cataract can be anterior polar cataract or posterior polar cataract. Now coming to the senile immature cataract. Senile immature cataract is the most commonest type of the acquired cataract. It is usually seen in patients who are more than 50 years of age. It can affect both sexes equally and usually it is bilateral, that is one eye is affected earlier than the other. And morphologically it can be divided into nuclear cataract or sclerotic cataract and cortical cataract. Nuclear cataract is also known as hard cataract. And cortical cataract are the soft cataracts. They are again of two types, cuneiform and cupulic form, of which cuneiform cataract is more common. Nuclear and cortical cataract can coexist in the same eye. Now coming to the mechanism of loss of transparency, in cortical cataract with the increasing age, there is decrease in the function of the active transport pump mechanism of the lens, that is the sodium potassium pump, which keeps the dehydrated state of the lens. Now there is a reversal of this sodium potassium pump, due to which there is hydration of the lens fiber, which leads to denaturation of lens proteins and opacification of the cortical lens fiber. There is also a reduced oxidative reaction, which leads to decreased synthesis of protein fiber proteins in the lens fiber, which also causes opacification of the lens fiber. In nuclear senile cataract, there is intensification of the age-related nuclear sclerosis, which is associated with dehydration and compaction of the nucleus, leading to hard cataract. Significant increase in water insoluble protein. Also, there is sometimes deposition of a pigment urochrome or melanin, which is derived from amino acids in the lens. Now, coming to the stages of maturation. In cortical cataract, there are five stages of maturation. First is the stage of lamellar separation. Second is stage of incipient cataract, which can be of two types, cuneiform and cupuliform. Third is the immature senile cataract. Fourth, the mature senile cataract. And fifth is the hypermature senile cataract. It again can be of two types, Morganian and sclerotic. The first is the last stage of lamellar separation. In this, there is demarcation of the cortical fibers owing to their separation by fluid. It is only demonstrated by slit lamp examination, and the changes in the lamellar separation are reversible. Next is the incipient cataract. In incipient cataract, there are early detectable opacities with clear areas in between. There are two types, cuneiform and cupuliform. In cuneiform cataract, there are wedge-shaped opacities which extend from equator towards the center, and these opacities are present in both the anterior as well as in the posterior cortex. These opacities are first seen in the lower nasal quadrant, typically radial spoke-like pattern is seen on the oblique illumination. Since they start at periphery, visual disturbance is noted at a later stage. It causes irregularities in refraction, visual deterioration, and cornucopia. Next is the cupuliform cataract. In this, there is a saucer-shaped opacity developed just below the capsule in the center part of the posterior cortex. That's why it is also known as the posterior subcapsular cataract. These opacities gradually progress towards the equator. That is, the opacities develop in the center and then they extend towards the periphery. It lies in the visual axis, so it causes an early visual loss of vision, and it is best seen in retroillumination against the red fundus reflex. Coming to the stage of immature senile cataract. In the immature senile cataract, the opacification progresses further. Lens appears a grayish white, but the clear cortex is still present in between, due to which there is presence of iris shadow. Now, what is iris shadow? When the lens is visualized on an oblique beam, the oblique beam of iris thrown on the pupil, a crescentic shadow of the pupillary margin of iris is formed on the grayish opacity of the lens, as long as there is a clear cortex present between the opacity and the pupillary margin. When lens is completely transparent or opaque, no iris shadow is formed. So for formation of iris shadow, always there should be an opacity in the lens, and there should be a clear cortex between the opacity and the iris, so that the iris shadow is formed on the nuclear opaque surface. Hence, the presence of iris shadow is a sign of immature cataract. Sometimes lens may become swollen, known as the intermission cataract, due to progressive hydration of the cortical layers, and anterior chamber becomes shallow in these cases. Now, next is the stage of maturation. In mature cataract, there is complete opacification of the lens. The whole cortex is involved, and lens appears as a pearly white in color. It is also known as the ripe cataract, and because of the complete opacification, no iris shadow is visible. If mature cataract is not treated, then in some cases it goes into stage of hypermature. In hypermature cataract, the cortex is disintegrated and transformed into a pultaceous material, usually occurs in two forms, Morganian and scleral. In Morganian cataract, the cortex is liquefied and appears milky white in color. Lens is converted into bag of milky fluid, and due to which the nucleus settles at the bottom, seen as a brown mass. Nucleus changes its position with the change of the position of head. In sclerotic hypermature cataract, also known as the shrunken cataract, the cortex is disintegrated, shrunken lens due to leakage of water. The anterior capsule is thickened due to proliferation of the anterior tubercle cells. The dense white capsular cataract is seen in the pupillary area. Anterior chamber becomes deep. There is tremulousness of the iris and subluxation of the lens due to degeneration of the suspensor ligament can occur. Coming to the maturation of the nucleus senile cataract, progressive nucleus sclerosis leads to lens inelastic and becomes hard. There is decrease in the ability to accommodate and may become diffusely cloudy or tinted. Tinted nucleus can be of a brown, black, or reddish color. Accordingly, the cataracts are named as cataract of Brusen's, cataract of Niagara, and cataract of Rubra. So, coming to the clinical features of the cataract, patient usually comes with the symptoms of blurring of vision and diminution of vision, which is gradual in progress and painless in nature. Patient also complains about glare. Then the patient will give history of frequent changes of glasses. There is second sight or myopic shift. Then colored halos around the light and diplopia or polyopia. Coming to the signs, the visual acuity due to cataract is reduced. It can be around 6-9 to perception of light, depending upon the stage of maturation of cataract. And this visual acuity is not improving with the pinhole because of the opacity. On oblique illumination, there is change in the color of the lens. Depending upon the stage of maturation, there are different colors of the lens. In the immature senile cataract, the lens appears a grayish white in color. In mature senile cataract, the lens can be a pearly white with the sinking brown nucleus. In hypermature senile sclerotic cataract, the lens is dirty white with the hyper white spots. And in a Morganian cataract, the lens is milky white in color. Depending upon the color of the nucleus, in type 1 nucleus sclerosis, it is greenish in color. In type 2, it is yellowish. In 3, it is amber. And in grade 4, it is brownish in color. Iris shadow in immature senile cataract is present. Then in distant direct ophthalmoscopy, black shadow is seen against the red fundal globe. On slit lamp examination done in fully dilated pupil reveals a complete morphology of the. Now this is a LOGS 3 classification, that is the lens opacity classification system grades into three types, that is the grading is done according to the type of cataract and the stage of maturation. It can be nuclear, cortical and posterior subcapsular cataract. Nuclear, depending upon the color of the nucleus, is graded into N0, 1, 2, 3. And cortical again 1, 2, 3 and 4, and posterior subcapsular cataract into PI, P2 and P3. Coming to the congenital cataract. Congenital cataract occurs due to disturbance in the normal growth of the lens before birth. It is limited to fetal or embryonic nucleus. In developmental cataract, it occurs from infancy or adolescence and may involve the infantile or adult nucleus and deeper parts of the cortex and capsule. Coming to the etiology, 33% cases are idiopathic. Hereditary is in with or without systemic disorders, and maternal factors which contribute to the cataract formation are malnutrition, then infections like rubella, toxoplasma and cytomegalovirus at the time of pregnancy, then intake of drugs like thalidomide and corticosteroids, and radiation. Fetal or infantile factors leading to cataract are anoxia, birth trauma, metabolic disorders like galactosemia, galactokinase deficiency, neonatal hypoglycemia, malnutrition, and ocular diseases associated are PHPV, aniridia, and ROP. Coming to the clinical types of congenital or developmental cataract, congenital capsular cataract, that is anterior or posterior capsular cataract, then polar cataract can be anterior and posterior. Then congenital nuclear cataracts include cataracta centralis pulvirulenta, lamellar cataract, sutural cataract, and total nuclear cataract. Generalized cataracts are coronary, blue dot, total congenital cataract, and membranous cataract. This is the anterior polar cataract, blue dot cataract, and sutural cataract, nuclear and lamellar cataract. This is the coronary cataract.